facing off against the Top Gun. I'm Dan Stevens. I'll be calling the game, and as always, Peter O'Keefe will deliver the color. Okay, Peter, let's review the lineups in today's game.
These are two guys that bring greatness to a team. They make a good team great. And the rest of the All-Pros in this list are no slouches either. On the other side, we see just as much talent, maybe even more. So these two guys are a couple of the best to play at their respective positions. They show up every game and put it all on the line. They lead their squads admirably.
Yes, indeedy, Peter. Now let's go to midfield for the coin toss.
The Top Gun. We'll make the selection. What is the call?
Give us tails.
Tails it is.
Sends it away to begin the game. Mathis decides to take it out of the end zone. The 18.
Billy Mathis got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Top Guns send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 18-yard line.
Jason Cook sticks to his blockers like a kick me sign as he runs the football.
Well, yeah, that's a pretty vivid description, but I'll tell you, it works. And the play works, too, as he surges across the line for a big game.
Yeah, it's all about using your blockers, Dan. They clear a path, you use the path.
Peter, that will put a touchdown in his stat column.
And that's always nice to have, Dan. So far, he's got 82 yards and one touchdown.
Good.
Don't get jammed, guys. This is nothing. Nothing. When we get the lead, let's get back out there and crack some heads.
Bailey boots it away. James is coming out with it. The 26.
Raymond James took it out of the end zone. Now, it may have been a little risky. He gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Riders bring their offense on the field and will start the drive at their own 26-yard line.
He just got sacked, son!
Keith Hunter forced the offense back a few yards with a terrific sack in the backfield.
The defensive design worked flawlessly, and the refs will spot the ball well behind the original line of scrimmage.
What a way to derail a series from the onset.
Second and long ahead. Second down, three wideouts in the game. Dardot threw that one away. Incomplete pass. We have a penalty marker on the play. Let's get the call from the field.
Holding, number 26.
Jai Lane got a fistful of his man to try and wrap him up on that play, but the ref saw it, and that's a clear-cut case of defensive holding.
Number 26 gets the ball and maybe picks up one on the play.
Number 26 ran forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more. The coverage and into his receiver's hands. Nice throw.
That touchdown will cut it close, Peter.
That was a big play. Way to stay in the game.
Number 9 booms one downfield. Mathis decides to take it out of the end zone. The 20.
Corey Mathis took it out of the end zone. While it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20. So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Top Guns got into the end zone last time they had it, and they're looking to do it again. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Curtis just rifles this one, and he connects for a pickup of 4 on the play.
Number 17 had a defender playing him close, but shook him at the last moment. You can't coach that.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Curtis fires this one. The reception's made at the 38. Eventually tackled at the 42. First down, both tight ends left. Heads left, tackle at the 46.
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
Well, on first and five, and they easily convert, Peter.
Yeah, that's what happens when the defense gives you yards off the penalty. Hugs the sidelines there and comes up with a huge run past the markers. Outstanding.
You know, speaking of hugs, Peter,
yeah?
We have never in all of our years of broadcasting together ever really hugged.
Well,
the Riders are challenging. One of the passes is caught and down.
Dan, when we check out the replay here, we should be able to see if the catch was made prior to going out of bounds. I'd call that incomplete. It doesn't look like he got both feet into me, but we'll see what they say.
After review, the pass has been ruled incomplete. The catch was made out of bounds. The Riders will not be charged with a timeout. Fourth down.
Number six gets ready to punt it away. Number six takes the long snap and punts it away. Let the punt bounce for a touchback.
Number six saw his kick go squarely on him for a touchback. Tough luck.
The Riders had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Number 20. Takes it upfield. Hammered down at the 35.
Six took advantage of some really good blocking there. They opened up a hole.
And he's able to cross the line and get a bunch more without really much resistance.
And that's what the O-line gets paid for.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Listen up. We got pair slots for the tight end out and in. Break!
Break!
Alexander Harris did a beautiful job on that last play covering the post route. That pass never had a chance. Incomplete.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
On this one, but is able to stay one step ahead for the completion. It's worth another look here. Oh yeah, the D might want to put more men on him next time.
A nice gain, and they easily convert on third down.
Yeah, that was a good call.
Gardani.
Was assisted on that play by some great blocking to open up holes for him. Without those blockers, he would have been toast.
A decent play, and they'll now face third and short.
That's the key, Dan. Make third down easy, and they did just that.
Now they just need to convert. We'll see what they do.
Well, we got an excellent running tandem in the backfield, Dan. Watch out for them here.
Fourth down coming up.
Rick Barton executed a beautiful backfield tackle there to back him up. An awesome hit.
That's his second tackle so far. Number nine crushes this one deep. Matthew bounds it for a touchback. The Top Guns had their last drive stall at the tail end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 20-yard line. Curtis lets it go down the right side. It's tipped. Incomplete.
And Allen couldn't get all the way positioned for the interception, but still managed to graze the ball with his fingertips.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up.
Big play coming up.
Curtis throws a flat end, and it's complete at the 23, and he's stopped right there. Moss with the tackle. That will bring up fourth down.
Derek Moss brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some game there, but not enough for the first.
The defense didn't budge on that play, and they force a fourth down. Number six takes the snap and punts it away. James catches it, gets the 37. Back down at the 39. The Riders will start a drive with the lead for the first time this game. We'll begin at their 39-yard line. Number 26 gets the ball on first down and gets taken down near the line and actually loses a bit.
Keith Hunter read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Helps him get a little momentum going, and then he's smart enough to make the right running choices downfield.
It's so dangerous when he busts loose like that. A highlight reel play.
What a run, Peter, and his numbers are adding up.
Adding up to one big number. Up to now, he's got 41 yards on six carries.
Number 26 carries it for a third time in a row and maybe picks up one on the play. The Riders with a small lead, 10-7.
We're going with guns. Wide left, 50 red plus. Break.
Let's go.
Now watch how he sneaks this ball past multiple defenders.
Yeah, it takes a considerable amount of poise and confidence to execute a play like this.
Great pass, Peter, and he's having a terrific day so far.
You bet. So far, he's got 152 yards and no interceptions.
This man, that was incredible.
Smith got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
That will be his fourth tackle, and he's hitting hard out there in the secondary.
Well, he's making them think twice before going his direction.
Number 26.
Sanders has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
This is a take-no-prisoners kind of guy when he is in the red zone.
Oh, after piling up some good yardage on the day, he makes a big play here for a score.
Number 9 crushes this one deep. Mathis decides to take it out of the end zone. To 23. The Top Guns stalled early last drive. We'll have to see what happens here. We'll start at their own 23-yard line. Third down, and they line up with three tight ends. Number 57. It's a play on this and forces the incompletion. It'll be fourth down.
Number 57 anticipated the trajectory of that pass and stuck his hand in at the last moment. Great play.
That was a fantastic job by the defense to stop what would have been a first down.
I love to see Big D on third and short situations. Fourth down, defenses love to hear that from the refs.
Number 6 takes the snap and hits a beauty. James fields the deep. The 29.
Raymond James dropped pretty deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Riders come out on offense, and they are well. well ahead. They'll start this drive at their own 29-yard line. Second down with the tight end right. Into a third and short situation. This is a critical play for this drive.
Yeah, now Dan, they can just fall forward and make the play.
Sounds easy, Peter, but we'll see if they can pull it off. Number 26 runs into traffic. Hitty penetrates and makes the stop at the 36. It'll be fourth down.
DeShawn Gideon would not be denied and dropped him for a huge loss. Big play.
They take away any and all room and prevent that play from getting past the line of scrimmage. Fourth down coming up. Number 6 takes the snap and punts it away. Dixon fields the punt at the 23.
Larry Dixon has a nice return coming up here off this punt. Watch. It's impressive the way he can make the right choices to keep the run back going. You can't coach that.
The Top Guns have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive that starts at their 44-yard line. Coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Eventually runs out of bounds at the 44. It will be first down.
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
What a run, Peter, and his numbers are adding up.
Adding up to one big number. Up to now, he's got 113 yards on 10 carries. Sit down, buddy. You're not going anywhere. Sure, he hits him hard now, but then after the game, they'll go out for a beer and make up. No, not really.
Peter, he's really gotten after the quarterback in this game.
Oh, you can say that again. So far, he's got 2 tackles and 2 sacks.
Sherman takes a play on this and forces the incompletion. Fourth down
William Sherman.
The man got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception.
Peter, the defense stood tall and forced the incompletion, but I don't understand that call. They wouldn't have gotten right. much at all, even if it was complete.
Fourth down either way, and in my opinion, too, a bad call.
Number six lines up for the punt. Number six takes the snap and punts it away. Let the punt
bounce
for a touchdown.
Number six.
This kid goes squarely on it for a touchback. Tough one.
This is what we're going to do. Triple 50, eight screen weep, and break.
First and 10.
Number 26 catches a wind of that and loses yards on that one.
Number 26 didn't quite get back to the line on that run and goes out of bounds.
They could not get this one across the line, Peter. Not the best execution there in my book.
True, but a bit of a loss on first isn't going to kill you.
That'll bring up second down. Oh.
Had that ball in his hands on that play, and then he just dropped it.
That's a good example of how he's not yet reached his full potential.
First drop pass of the game for him, and his quarterback hopes it's his last.
How about blocking this thing? Come on, let's swarm this guy.
Let's go.
Number six takes the snap and punts it away.
Dixon puts it in at the 37 and at the 39.
Larry Dixon didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Top Guns haven't gotten much out of their offense recently and are looking to get back on track here. This drive begins at their 39-yard line.
One. Let's watch. Yep, the D shut the offense down on that play. They couldn't do anything.
That sack will give him a total of 3 on the day. What a performance.
Showtime.
Third down.
Yeah, they have a ways to go, Dan. They would have loved a few more yards out of that play.
Third down from the eye.
Alan Davis, with the offense back a few yards with a terrific sack in the backfield.
4 on the game for this defense. They've made their presence felt.
Yes, they have, Dan.
Number 6 lines up the punt after the 3 and out. Number 6 takes the snap and hits a beauty. James fields the punt at the 21. At the 28.
Damon James got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Riders come out on the field and are looking to extend their lead before the break. They'll start at their own 28-yard line. Just couldn't cover him. Man up, plain and simple.
Yeah, great catch and execution.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
There, it'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more. Coming up.
Gardot throws up the completion is made. And the lead worked down.
Terry Bowman out of bounds after getting some yardage, but you can tell that it wasn't as much as he wanted.
They get some yards out of that play, but they are short.
Yeah, didn't get quite the punch they wanted to.
Number 6 gets ready to punt it away. Number 6 takes the long snap and punts it away. Let the punt bounce for a touchdown.
Number 6. Saw his kick go squarely on for a touchback. Tough luck.
The Top Guns. They have taken the field and they've been having a tough time passing the ball. They have another opportunity here as we start at their own 20-yard line.
Moment to scramble back there, and it worked out.
first down.
William Sherman eventually gets there, but I don't know why he even bothered. Big gain, and they'll move the chains. Well, he eventually stops him, but way past the marker, this one's going to hurt.
A poor job by the defense. Not only do they give up the conversion, but a few more yards beside.
Yeah, they got to give this offense more trouble, Dan. They're making it look too easy.
First down from the shotgun. Second down, the clock is stopped at 3. And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Riders enjoying the lead, 17-7.
Okay, Dan, let's get this halftime show started. What do you have for us?
Now we'll look at our halftime comparison, and as you can see, total yards definitely tell the story thus far. The Riders are winning because of it. Let's see if they can keep up their dominance in the second half. Let's get started in this one early in the first quarter. Cook takes the handoff here, and look at the blocking at the point of attack. A big opening up the middle. An 83-yard touchdown for the visitors. The Top Guns strike first and go up by 7. Trying to answer back, Patton was definitely a key player as he was able to work his way open for a big one here. A 73-yard touchdown for the home team. Midway through the first, game tied, 7-all. Curtis would find his target on this one. The Riders, still midway through the first quarter, Gardocki went up top on a third down play, and he was able to find his man. That set up a short 25-yard field goal. The Riders leading 10-7. Number 26 is going to show a little athleticism here as he finds an opening, and then he's off to the races. A 25-yard play that set up a home team touchdown. The Riders move ahead by 10. Late into the second quarter, the ball at their own 27. Gardocki connected with his man on this one. Unfortunately, the drive stopped shortly afterwards, and they had to punt it away. Still late in the second quarter, the Top Guns back by 10. Cook got the call on third down, and it paid off. And that's where we'll have to leave this one. The Riders are up big at the half, 17-7.
Excellent job, Dan.
The Riders get the ball first this half, and another score by them could really open up this game. They currently lead 17-7. Let's get down to the field and the action. Second half kickoff away. James catches it back at the one.
Aiden James received that nice kick and a nice little run back after the catch. Good job.
We have to make a statement on this series.
Thank you.
second down. Number 26 gets caught. Passed the line, but not by much before being brought down.
Number 26 stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
Not a lot of room on that play. It will be third down.
This one perfectly. Great pass, great catch, great play. Let's have another look. Bullseye, what a precise throw. They keep doing plays like this, the D could be in big trouble.
Nice pass, Peter, and he's really lighting up the stat sheet.
Oh, you got it. So far, he's got 210 yards and two touchdowns.
This one. Tight triple strong G-tall. Focus on this one. Break!
Big play.
That will be his fourth tackle so far. What do you think of his performance, Peter?
Solid game, Dan. Really carrying his sizable weight out there. Sanders gonna make a great run after the catch. Oh, there he snags the football, then fires up the jets. That's big time talent.
That's yet another downfield shot to the same location.
And this guy really has a feel for adjusting to the deep ball. You can't coach that.
The defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got five tackles and one sack. On a quick pattern.
They just couldn't cover him man up, plain and simple.
Yeah, great catch and execution.
This is a take no prisoners kind of guy when he is in the red zone.
Oh, after piling up some good yardage on the day, he makes a big play here for a score.
It's good.
Number 9 hits a boomer down the field. Matthew pounds it in the end zone for a touchdown. The Top Guns are fading fast and desperately need to score. Their offense will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Second down, just a single receiver on the field.
Mark Ford all down the quarterback for the loss of a little yardage and a lot of momentum.
Sacked by this defensive squad, and they have generated, well, some very shocking numbers so far.
I don't know about shocking, but turf beating, yes.
Perkins lets it go the distance here, and Fulham finally stopped at the 29.
Larry Dixon really delivers on this play. Let's take another look first at the catch.
There it is, but he's not done. He's going to make his way forward for extra yards.
Oh, he's a go-to guy for sure.
Peter, no one seems to be able to stop this guy on the left side. They found him a few times over there.
Yeah, he's been running sharp routes, but it makes you wonder about the coverage over to that area. Number 57 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's his third tackle of the game.
Let's go!
Dixon
did his teammate a favor with that key block downfield. This is an offense in which everybody plays their parts perfectly on every down.
Nice play, and they will convert on third.
Great execution, Dan. They did everything right.
Curtis throws a heater right sideline, and he connects for a pickup of four on the play.
Mark Curtis demonstrated his arm strength back there with a solid cross-field pass.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Second down coming up on the 10th play of the drive.
Dixon snatched it out of the air without any challenge from the defense, Dan. You know, my grandmother could have covered him better.
This guy can really twist up the coverage in that short area.
That's right, Dan. Those quick routes have been open for him all day. Obviously, that's what the defense wants to give him.
First down.
Jason Cook got a little help from his friends on that play, Dan. They gave him the space he needed to make the play. Great blocking up front.
A big gain on third, and they will easily move the chain.
Perfect call for the situation, Dan. No trouble in getting the first. Targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got 5 tackles and 4 sacks. Tremendous job on that last play, guarding against the post pattern. That pass went incomplete.
The defense denies the opportunity for the score and instead forces them into a fourth down situation.
Pressure cooker of a play, and the D played it tight. Short one through the uprights. Hey, it's 3 points no matter how close you are.
Bailey booms one downfield. James is coming out with it. 1 man to beat. Number 9 boots the heck out of this one. Mathis is coming out with it.
Mathis got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Top Guns came away with 3 last time out and are looking for more. They'll start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Curtis lobs this one over the middle. Stopped at the 34.
Kurt Warner hit
picks off the pass because he plays the zone so well here, completely snookering the quarterback. That's just how you do it, folks. You can't coach that.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
Here we go, guys. A strong zone cutback.
The Riders are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at the 34-yard line. The ball and picks up a couple. Third down, two wideouts on the field. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Roderick Kidd snuck across the middle that time, but could not make a play on the ball.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. It from 46 yards out.
Number nine rockets this one in for a clean field goal. Let's see it again.
He's got plenty of room on either side. Great accuracy there.
Well, you could have backed up that one 10 yards or so. He still probably would have made it.
Number nine boots the heck out of this one. Matthew is coming out with
it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Top Guns are now on the field, and except for a few big plays, they can't be happy with their passing game. We'll see what they call on this drive as we start at their own 18-yard line. Second down.
Pick up a three on the play. Allen with the tackle.
Playmaker.
Second and seven. From the top down, 21 yards.
Seven read that play perfectly and makes the tackle behind the line, pushing them back a few yards in the process. Great effort.
That will be his fourth tackle of the contest.
For the interception, but still managed to graze the ball with his fingertips.
That was the fourth time they've swatted the ball out of the air, and the offense is looking frustrated.
The D is showing excellent fundamentals right now.
It away. James Fields the ball at the 43. The 44.
Damon James got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Riders will begin the drive at their 44-yard line. Number 26 picks up about two, and that will bring up second down.
Number 26 had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Riders in command of this one, 34-10.
Showtime!
Kennedy targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got five tackles.
Third down and four wideouts in the game. Gardaki throws the
catch despite being double covered. What do you have to do to intimidate this guy? Well, he never takes his eye off the ball, Dan, even as he's bracing for the hit.
It takes a lot of courage to make your living over the middle, I'll tell you, but we've seen him there several times today.
Yeah, that's a guy who's willing to sacrifice his body to make his quarterback look good.
Number 26 takes it on his 23rd carry.
John Gideon targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Gardaki throws this up.
Cleland ran a post pattern on that last one, but the ball eluded him. No catch.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down. Third down, 10 yards to go.
Todd Hughes chases his man down and gets him before the marker. It's worth another look. Yep, he let some yards get by, but he made the stop when he had to.
There's a migraine waiting to happen for the defensive coordinator. They almost gave it up.
Yeah, but they didn't let him convert. It's still going to go to fourth down.
Fourth and short. Fourth down and less than a yard. It from 33 yards, puts it through, it's good.
Number 9 puts in an easy short one. A clean kick, no worries.
They'll take the 3 points, but they were hoping for 7.
But that's the second time today they get close only to have to bring in the kicker.
Number 9 brushes this one deep. Mathis decides to take it out of the end zone at the 21.
Corey Mathis got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Top Guns have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive that starts at their own 21-yard line. Gains 3 yards, and that brings up second down.
Gain of 3 on the play. Tate credited with the tackle.
Right.
Second and 7.
Curtis uncorks a dynamite pass there with two defenders on the prowl.
Really incredible accuracy, but I'll tell you, that's got to sting if you're on the defense.
Righto, Dano. You know, they could have brought eight guys on that play. Wouldn't have made a difference. Dan, I've seen a lot of short throws, but overall, there's really not much to show for.
Good catch, solid throw, but the ball just isn't moving far enough to make a difference. First down, both wideouts to the right.
Carlos Tate got a great jump on the play and brings the ball carrier down for a loss in the backfield. Nice defensive stop.
That will be his fourth tackle, and he's hitting hard out there in the secondary.
Well, he's making them think twice before going his direction.
Curtis tips it to the left sideline, and it's on it down at the 48. First down.
The catch, but watch here what he does after the completion. Caught, and now fight for more yards. You can't coach that.
Ooh, that guy was rumbling. He's not exactly fleet of foot, you know, but on that last play, he spun his wheels and really dug in for those extra yards.
And when you barrel down the field like a Mack truck, you don't need to be fleet of foot. Number 57 got the sack, but he was totally unblocked. You need to at least lay a hand on somebody to slow him down.
That'll be his first sack of the game.
Shot him the ball.
Well, you know, this is just not working. He made a good play on the ball, but for what?
This team is always throwing short. Problem is, they're not picking up any significant yardage after the catch.
Exactly.
Thank you.
John Roy is way late here on this hit. What was he thinking? Check it out. Oh, yeah, that's unnecessary roughness. No excuse for a late hit like that.
It's good.
The point is good.
Bailey booms one downfield. James decides to take it out of the end zone. The 22.
Brandon James took it out of the end zone. While it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20. So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Riders offense takes the field, and they will start at their own 22-yard line.
Carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
He now has five tackles in the game. Second down, one man back. Dardani zings the ball is caught for a gain of 7 on the play.
Howard Gardocki made a nice throw there, got it right past the defender.
Another terrific throw and completion. This team is piling up serious yardage and putting consistent pressure on the defense.
Consistency, 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 even into the fourth quarter. If they keep this up, Dan, they'll have this game locked down.
Sounding almost Shakespearean.
Sanders ran out of bounds there, well short of where he wanted to go.
Peter, they couldn't get the last few yards they wanted, and now it is fourth down.
Boy, a good call, right. But as you said, they just couldn't get the last few yards they needed.
Gets the snap and punts it away. Nixon fields it. The 32. The Top Guns passed well last time out. We'll see if they stick to the passing game as they start this drive at their 32-yard line.
Dixon makes the catch and then adds a whole lot more on the ground. Watch. Reels it in and then makes the D reel with all the yards he's tacking on.
He gets the touchdown off a nice play. Fantastic athleticism.
What a player.
And
That's good.
The point is good.
Bounces it up there. Collects it at the 41. Brought down at the 42. Morton with the tackle.
Darrell Johnston didn't waste any time grabbing that onside kick. He didn't want to give the kicking team any chance at it.
They can't bring down the onside kick. Pretty aggressive play calling there, though.
Well, the offense is like a 1-in-4 chance of recovering those, but they knew the risks.
The Riders have a short field and are starting this drive at the 42-yard line.
Number 26 was assisted on that play by some great blocking to open up holes for him. Without those blockers, he would have been toast.
Nice second down call, and they will move the chain.
On offense, it was always a plus to avoid third down altogether, just like that.
Second down, two tight ends in the game.
Split twins, strong fold sweep. Focus on this one. Break!
Five on the play clock. Third down. The clock is stopped at 2 minutes. Number 26. Take their first time out.
Rick Barton brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
He's now up to 6 tackles. From 39 yards out, puts it through, it's good.
Number 9 sends it whizzing between the goalposts for a field goal.
Straight
great down the pike.
4 for 4. Fantastic job of kicking the ball so far.
You gotta love kickers that are automatic like that.
Number 9 booms one downfield. Mathis is coming out with it.
So it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Top Guns start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 1:48.
Mark Curtis threw an incomplete pass there. You know, maybe that's lucky since there were two defenders in that zone.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down. Third down, 3 wideouts in the game.
See them start to anticipate the path of the throw the minute the quarterback winds up. Effort back there. They got a few yards, but not the first.
They stopped them cold. Fourth coming up.
Right. Exactly what this defense needed to do.
Fourth down, and they're going for it. Fourth down, and that will be it for them.
Yeah, chalk this one up in the L column, Dan. It's all over.
Yeah. takes a knee, and that will do it. Bradley takes a knee, and the clock will tick down. And that will do it for tonight's game. The Riders come out on top, 40-24. With this one in the books, let's take a look back at some of the action. So, the ball game is over. Let's take a quick look back at how it went with our post-game show. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Gardocki went to the air trying to convert on third down, and he found his man. A 42-yard play that set up a home team touchdown. The Riders have opened it up and now lead by 17. The Top Guns, midway through the third, Curtis went up top on the third down play, and he was able to find his man. That set up a piece of cake, 18-yard field goal. Towards the end of the third quarter, the Riders leading by 14. James is back to return this thing, and he shakes off the first few guys, and there he goes. They have opened it up and now lead by 21. The Top Guns on D. Warner would come up with the big play to kill a drive as he was able to step in front of a wayward pass for an INT. The Top Guns down 31-10. After driving 5 yards on 3 plays, number 9 sets up for a long one here, and he's got plenty of oomph behind this one. It's through the uprights. A 47-yard field goal. The Riders move ahead by 24. Now early in the fourth quarter, ball at their own 45. Gardocki went to work on third down, and he was able to find his man. That set up a 33-yard field goal. Midway through the fourth, the Top Guns losing by 27. Curtis went up top on a third down play, and he was able to find his man. They're trying to make something happen and are now down by 20. The Top Guns, still middle of the fourth. Dixon was definitely a key player as he was able to work his way open for a big one here. A 68-yard touchdown for the visitors. The Top Guns back 37-24. After driving 20 yards on 5 plays, number 9 is summoned for the field goal attempt. Good snap, good spot, good kick. Hey, 3 points. A 40-yard field goal. The Riders now up by 16. Still late in the fourth quarter, number 17 found a soft spot in the defense, and it worked to his advantage. Unfortunately, they couldn't capitalize on the big play, and they turned the ball over on down. And that's where we'll have to leave this one. The Riders come away with a win, 40-24. Let's wrap it up by congratulating our 2K Sports Player of the Game.
Howard Gardocki turned in yet another legendary outing. Well, he was the best player on the winning team. It's as simple as that. We'll see if he's able to keep up this high level of play in the games ahead.
For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.